It seems to me guys and gals backstage are walking on eggshells. They're trepidatious. They're a little afraid to really go out on a limb because there is no other option. And no, if they piss somebody, if they tick somebody off well, then, you know, there goes their career.
Well, don't piss anybody off.
I pissed a lot of people off. I had
I know you have.
I wanted to challenge the locker room.
Well,
go ahead.
This is a different group of guys and gals. It's millennials. You know, they're not as ambitious, quite frankly. And they're not trepidatious at all. I just don't think they necessarily want to reach for that brass ring. The last person who really reached for that brass ring, in all likelihood, was John Cena. Now, there are others coming up now who definitely want to reach for it. Ambrose is one of them. Seth Rollins is another one. Roman Reigns is another one. Bray's another one. So I think you've got some people here who are chomping at the bit to make a difference. But when you're walking around, you know, backstage, you don't hear as much, you know, camaraderie, perhaps, and laughter as in your era.
Shenanigans.
But then again, you know, there's some other things that they do. You know,
but you just said this locker room wasn't as ambitious as the one I was in.
I would suggest that's correct.
Why is that?
It's a different, again, I said it's millennials. It's a different point of view. Well, if you reach for that brass ring and you fall on your butt, no one wants to fail. And there's this feeling that, you know, this insecurity that if you fail, you're exposed.
Right.
So, I think that's largely pretty much what it is. Because you give everybody the opportunities, you give everyone resources, which you never had. You know, the things that we do now from a television production standpoint, social media, oh my God, social media is huge. You know, it helps talent in so many different ways. It gives them the tools that you didn't have, other people like you did not have. It's utilization of those tools that's very important for talent to use. And they do use them, you know, but not in a way you did.
What happened? So I agree completely. SmackDown is a better show. Look at Alexa Bliss. It's a land of opportunity. She is an incredibly talented young lady. She flourished at SmackDown. SmackDown has always been the better show. 04, 05, 06. SmackDown was a better show then. SmackDown is a better show now. Look at what happens in the women's division. I guarantee you, we can take the same women that Raw has, put them on SmackDown, and they will flourish. The same thing with any superstar.
Well,
SmackDown's a land of opportunity.
04, 05, 06. Okay, SmackDown, the conversation. What about 09, 10, 11. Was SmackDown better then?
No, it wasn't. I thought it went through a huge slump. And I'm not sure what happened, but you had the
one heck of a performance last night. I did it, people. And you know what I also did? I did something that was seemingly impossible for the other cruiserweights. I made 205 Live relevant. Relevant. Relevant.
There's only one era, so groundbreaking.
You made your rules, and we...
There's only one era, so groundbreaking. There's only one era, so groundbreaking.
You got a lot of nerve coming out here after what you pulled last night.
What I pulled? So let me just get this correct. I'm standing in the ring with Kurt Angle, Brock Lesnar, and the father of hardcore himself, Paul Heyman, and you said I went too far? Are you kidding me? You guys were all a part of the Attitude Era. We all know how that went. You destroyed everything. You blew everything up. That was then, this is now.
Check it out. Tonight on Raw, Alexa Bliss, this is my life.
Terrible idea.
What?
This is your life from last week was one of the worst segments in the history of Raw. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Pour all over my face. Oh, I know, I can do something even better. Douse me in paint, just like Finn Balor, so you can hopefully forget that I'm a charisma vacuum.